हरि ओम सहनाभवतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ओम शांति 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 I'm Dr. Bhatt. I've been asked to conduct today's Antya Samskara of Sriman Sadhu Ram Ji. It's a very hard time, painful time for the wife, children, son-in-laws, daughter-in-laws, grandchildren, friends and other relatives. We pray Lord Paramatma to give them all enough strength to see over, to pass over this painful period. Still, his thoughts and his memories will remain with all of us. That's what he wants, not to keep on mourning, but to go get along with our life. That will make him happy. During this situation, we try to remind ourselves, what is this jiva, or we call atma, and what is this body, the relationship, and also who is Paramatma, what he has got to do with all these things. These are very closely related, integrated, three parts. Paramatma is the one who is eternal, the one whose existence is beyond the scope of this universe. The whole universe came into existence from him, as we hear from Purusha Sukta. And this Atma is a spark that came out of Paramatma himself. So we can't call ourselves as Paramatma, but we are a spark, a part of him. And this jiva, the body, that was a house given to this Atma to live in. Like when we come, we need a house, we rent a house. The house owner is somebody else. We rent the house, we live there, we enjoy ourselves. At the end, we return the house back to the owner and then go away. Similarly, the Atman was given this body to enjoy itself, to improve itself, because human life is one of the most sacred of it. Here, we can obtain the ultimate mukti or the salvation. We have that capacity, but we don't do it. We squander it away by attaching to the worldly things, making money, by our jealousy, by our greed, by our passion. We need to have all these things within the limit. But ultimately, our aim should be to go back. The spark should go back to Paramatma. That is called moksha. That is what is needed. So Atman is as eternal as Paramatma. It never dies. It changes into different forms. We have been in a different form before. In the future, we will be in a different form. But in between, this body changes. When we are here to offer this mortal remains of the Ramji, Sadhu Ramji, it is our duty to cleanse it properly with the holy Ganga water, decorate it nicely, put a new cloth, and then in the sacred fire, offer it as a yajna, sacrifice, back to Paramatma. We say, Swaha, take this one back to you. We are offering to you. And it is the duty of the sons and the daughters, the children, to perform this act, to consider it to be one of the sacred acts, Shodasha Samskara, of the 16 samskaras, this is one of them. The son has to do to his parents. When somebody goes away, we give them some gifts to remember and say goodbye. Similarly, today, the Atman of Sadhu Ramji is on its way to the Pitraloka, and we need to give him some gifts on his way, and that is the gift of punya, virtue, so that he will be greeted with honor and will have his soul rest in peace. In the ancestor loka, what we call Pitraloka, along with his ancestors. These are the process to be done. In the future days, Sachin and his family will be going back to India to perform these various rituals so that the Atman of Sadhu Ramji stays in a good, very honorable position in the Pitraloka. So this punya, how we are going to go? During this short period here, we will chant some verses from Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is a conversation between Lord Krishna and Arjuna, the princess who refused to fight, and Krishna says, it is not your war. You are forced to do it. It's your duty to do it. So go ahead and do it. Don't think that you are killing anybody because they are your friends and your relatives. There's nothing like that. We are all part of one. We never leave. We never die. We are immortal. This message Lord Krishna gives to Arjuna, and every one verse of Bhagavad Gita, when you chant, you get that much punya or the virtue as if you are taking a bath in holy Ganga. That punya we are going to offer by chanting this mantra to Sadhu Ramji on his way to the journey to the Pitraloka. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Achoshvachana Shoschatam Prajnavadam Shabhasase Gata Sunu Gata Sumscha Nanu Sochanti Panditaha. The Blessed Lord Krishna said, you grieve for those who should not be grieved for, yet you spell words of wisdom. The wise grieve neither for living nor for dead. Natve vaham jatu nasam natvam neme janadhipa na chaivana bhavishyamaha sarve vayamata param. Nor I, nor you, nor any of these ruling princes in front of you was never non-existent before, nor it is that we shall cease to be in the future. Dehi nosmin yatha dehe komaram yavvanam jara tatha dehantara praptir diram trasyana muhyati. Lord says, as the indweller in the body experiences childhood, youth, and old age in this body, he also passes to another body. The serene one is not affected thereby. Matra sparshastu kaunteya sitoshna sukhadukkadaha agamamapino nitya stansim sikshasva bharatam. The contacts of senses with their objects create feelings of heat and cold, of pain and pleasure. They come and go. They are impermanent. Bear them patiently. Nasato vidyate bhavo, na bhavo vidyate sataha, ubhayorapi drishtotvam Stanyo dashasya darshibhi. The unreal has no existence. The body that we see around us, the physical thing made up of panchabhutas, the earth, water, fire, air and space, that's what this body is consisted of. It's impermanent. It's not permanent. It's unreal. It has no existence. The real never ceases to be. The Atman that lives within the body is never ceases to exist. The truth about them has been realized by the seers. Vasamsi jinani yatha vihaya nimani grahanani naroparani tatha sharirani vihana jirna nanyani samyani navani dehi. As a man casting off worn out garments puts on new ones, so the embodied casting of worn out bodies enters into other that are new. Nainam chindati shastrani nainam dahati pavakaha na chaina kledayantyapo na socha yati marutaha. You say, I don't want to kill these people with my weapons. Lord says, the weapons do not cleave the Atman. The fire bursts it not. The water wets it not. The winds dries it not. Paramatma further says, jatasya hi dhruvo mrityur dhruvam janma mrtasya cha tasmada parihariyarthe natvam shochitu marhasi. It is definite. Of those who was born has to die, and those who die, they're born again. This is the truth. Once you know the truth, there's nothing to be concerned about the fact. Avyaktadhani bhutani vyaktamadhyani bharata avyaktanidhananyema tatraka paridevana. Nobody knows where we were before. Only in the middle stage we came into existence. And then again, at the end, we go away. We don't know where it gone. So, being or all, unmanifested in the begin, in the origin, manifested in the middle stage, and unmanifested again at the end, what is the point for anguish? So, having read these few verses from Bhagavad Gita chapter 2, where Lord Paramatma explains Arjuna that what he is claiming to be, that what he is doing, he is killing, is not his, and the killing is not the end of the, it's only the end of this physical body, but not that of the Atman. Now I request Sachin to come forward and speak a few words about his dad.
Hello everyone. First of all, I would like to thank all the friends and relatives who have come great distances to be here for my dad. I am humbled and quite impressed at how he must have touched your lives. I would like to share a few reasons why I admire my dad. First and foremost was his love and commitment for my mother. They were happily married for 45 years. And during his last days, his biggest concern was for my mom's well-being and not his own impending mortality. I also admire him because of the kind of father he was to us. Yes, he loved us very much. He was a man who would go out of his way to help anyone in need. He was a man who kept promises, honored commitment. He was a man of integrity. He was the strongest man I knew who worked hard all his life. He was very fond of eating spicy Indian food. He loved and thoroughly enjoyed food prepared by my mom. He loved to celebrate every festival in all its glory, be it Diwali, Holi, or Basant Panchami. He would buy us kites, colors, firecrackers, toys, before we even could ask for it. If you are here today, and I thank you for that, that means he touched your lives in some way or another. Friends and family will miss his company and good humor. His grandchildren will miss his hugs and love. My mother will miss having her best friend at her side. On the day I lost you, I lost a father, a friend, a guide who I looked up to. May your soul rest in peace. I love you, Dad, to the moon and back. Miss you a lot. Thank you. I'll ask my wife, Savi, to come and have some words.
Namaste, everyone. I'm here to talk about a great man, my father-in-law, who I fondly call Daddy Ji. He was a very humble, loving, caring, family-oriented, compassionate, and happy person. Nothing I say can sum up what he means to us, but just his name, Sadhu Ram. Pure and pious like a saint, like a sadhu. Righteous, truthful, loving like Sri Ram. Caring for one and all. He was a man of divine character. I got married to Sachin 7 years ago, but the bond we shared was not of a father-in-law. It was of a doting father. He would support me more than he would support Sachin. He would care for my comfort more than he would care for Anuditi. He made sure that I saw every part of Delhi. He made sure I tried every food, be it pani puri or chaat, dosa or Chinese. He loved to entertain. He would lay the platter at any excuse. He made sure that he stood by every person he knew in their time of need. His friends were reverential towards him. They still are, and they will always be. I won't talk about his disease, because that's not how we want to remember him. Since he moved to Australia, he made more friends than we have, be it Indians or Australians. People we don't even know would come and visit us. The newspaper lady, the people from the petrol station, the people he met on his morning walks, his afternoon strolls, they would all come and pay and visit him. He was so charismatic that he touched everyone he met. We will always miss him. We will always treasure the memories that we made with him. Gog and uncle have been an immense support for us through all thick and thin. Mamaji and Mamiji made sure that he always had company. He would always sing for my son, Aryan, that you're my heart, my soul, my child. His words will always echo in our minds. He would carry his granddaughter, Janvi, even when he couldn't carry himself. Anubji have been an immense support through everything. He's been more of a son than a son-in-law. It's unfortunate that Daddy Ji didn't get enough time to spend with his family and with his grandkids, but he will always live with us through them. We love you, Daddy Ji. And I would just finish by saying, I never truly meant what the words I miss you meant until I reached for my dad's hand and it wasn't there. Thank you. Thank you, everyone, for coming. I'll just get Anubji to say a couple of words as well.
Hi, everyone. My name is Anoop. First of all, thanks for all to come here and support us. I don't have that much words to tell about Papa. I call myself Papa. It was every single time with me. My bad times, my good times, he always support me. And when I came to this family 7 years ago, I was a little bit confused actually. I'm coming from another part of India with different culture. When I came here, I was a little bit confused actually how we manage, me and Anuradha. But when I come actually, I realized this family was a very, very caring family, especially Papa. He support me a lot, each and every single moment. He was a caring father, he was a caring husband, he was a caring grandfather. Even in his bad time, he was always smiling at us actually. He never showed his pain. And till his end, he was with us. I never forget his presence in my life. He taught me everything in my life, especially how to become a father, how to become a... I don't have words. I miss you, Papa. Thank you.
There will be a short video depicting the life of Sadhu Ram. Thank you. Before we commit the mortal remains of Sadhu Ramji into the holy fire, I request the guests to come forward and take a few flower petals, shower it on the body and show their respect. In doing so, when you come, please remove your footwear where you are sitting, and then you can go back and put them back onto you. In the meantime, I will chant Sri Krishna Stotra Shatanama. Please come forward in two lines, one on that side and one on this side, and then you can go back. I request the family to come up first. Harihi Om Shri Krishnaya Namaha Kamalanathaya Namaha Om Vasudevaya Namaha Om Sanatanaya Namaha Om Vasudevatmajaya Namaha Om Punyaya Namaha Om Leelamanush Vigrahaya Namaha Om Shri Vatsa Kaustu Bhadaraya Namaha Om Yashoda Vatsalaya Namaha Om Haraye Namaha Om Chaturbhujhatta Chakrasi Gadhashankad Dhyudayudaya Namaha Om Devaki Nandanaya Namaha Om Shrishaya Namaha Om Nandagopa Priyatmajaya Namaha Om Yamuna Vega Samharine Namaha Om Balabhadra Priyanujaya Namaha Om Putana Jivitaharaya Namaha Om Shakatasura Bhanjanaya Namaha Om Nandavraja Janananda Namaha Om Sachidananda Vigrahaya Namaha Om Navanita Vileptangaya Namaha Om Navanita Natonagaya Namaha Om Anaghaya Namaha Om Navanita Namaharaya Namaha Om Muchukunda Prasadakrite Namaha Om Shodashastri Sahasreshaya Namaha Om Stribhangi Madhurakritaye Namaha Om Shukavaga Mritadbindave Namaha Om Govindaya Namaha Om Yoginam Pataye Namaha Om Vatsapada Haraya Namaha Om Anantaya Namaha Om Dhenukasura Bhanjanaya Namaha Om Trinikita Trinavrittaya Namaha Om Yamalarjuna Bhanjanaya Namaha Om Uttala Tala Bhetre Namaha Om Tamala Shamalakritaye Namaha Om Gopa Gopishwaraya Namaha Om Yogine Namaha Om Koti Surya Samaprabhaya Namaha Om Ilapataye Namaha Om Paranjotashe Namaha Om Yadavendraya Namaha Om Yadudvahaya Namaha Om Vanamaline Namaha Om Pitavasase Namaha Om Parijata Paharakaya Namaha Om Govardhana Chalodharte Namaha Om Gopalaya Namaha Om Sarvapalakaya Namaha Om Ajaya Namaha Om Niranjanaya Namaha Om Kamajanakaya Namaha Om Kanjalochanaya Namaha Om Madhugne Namaha Om Mathuranathaya Namaha Om Dwaraka Nayakaya Namaha Om Baline Namaha Om Vrindavananta Sancharine Namaha Om Tulasi Dhamabhushanaya Namaha Om Samantaka Mane Harte Namaha. Om Naranarayanatmakaya Namaha. Om Sri Krishnaya Namaha. Harihi Om. Now we are going to transfer the mortal remains of Sadhu Ramji into the back room, where the close family members will join, and we will have a small havan, and the fire from the havan will be lit onto the body, and the body will then be put into the furnace for further cremation. In the meantime, you are welcome to stay inside the hall. We got up to 1 o'clock. We should be able to finish it by then, and we will be coming back. Please stand up and chant Om Namo Narayanaya. 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 Om Namo. Put all the flowers onto there. Put all the flowers there.
After the service, I would like to invite all of you to please accompany us to home and have lunch with us. Thank you.
Days and nights falling by me. Never know.